Hey everyone, it's Kevin Jones with Life, Mind, and Money. Today we are going to be discussing what I believe the number one key to investing. It will probably come across to you as something very simple, but also as an intimidating thing to discuss. You know, investing is a crazy world out there, but we're going to break down the nature of investing and what I believe this is the number one key. So come along for this journey. If you haven't already done so, please hit that like button because it really helps the show a ton. So let's break down into today's subject. The market is a large and confusing place where you can invest in things like stocks and bonds and commodities and so on. There are so many things that you can invest in, and even crazy things like even pork bellies. Seriously, pork bellies. If you don't believe me, check out the 1980s movie Trading Places with Dan Aykroyd and Eddie Murphy, and you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. If you have never invested before, I can see the intimidation and why you have never started before. And that is why I'm going to get into the number one key to investing is actually investing. It sounds silly, but the reality is if you don't start putting your money into investments, even if it's just a simple index fund, your money will never have a chance to grow. You can learn all the mathematics of different stocks and bonds and everything else out there, but the reality is if you do not start, you will never start to begin to grow money and then become ultimately financially independent. Investing doesn't have to be a complicated thing. There are things like the index fund, which is a major fund like the S&P 500, which collects the top 500 companies and then tracks them on how they're doing in their business. I want to take an example here on the screen now, looking at the S&P 500 over the last 100 years. For those who would think that the investing world is intimidating, I want you to really understand the chart that's in front of you, and you will see a trend here that over the last 100 years, the market has been moving upward consistently. Yes, there are dips here and there from major geopolitical events, but the overall assumption of the market has been moving northward. And I think people didn't really recognize the fact that the market actually is a good place to put your money. And this chart should show you, especially over such a long history. While the S&P from the chart you just saw has its stability, also recognize that there are many investments out there that are tricky and hard to deal with, frankly, that none of us should ever be in. When we invest, we should only invest in things that we actually understand and really can stick to. We shouldn't be out there in the things that you see people doing on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange because they're into investments that are completely out of our own league. You will ultimately never be able to start growing a nest egg and start building towards your own financial independence and retirement if you don't invest at all. And that's why we go back to our number one key to investing. It's not about math. It's not about the science and the compound interest. Those are all great things in investing. But if you do not start putting money towards it, you will never grow. And that's why we have automatic investments and our retirement funds through our own employers who start matching. There's so many great programs out there that you should start diving into and start understanding, because if you don't start today, that money will never be ready for you when you're ready to retire and ultimately get away from your job and start doing things that you want to do in your own life. Even if you're scared, I recognize that, but you got to start somewhere. Even if you put your money in a small savings account or a certificate of deposit, a CD, or in a money market account and growing at a couple of percent, that is honestly better than nothing. In time, you will learn more about how mutual funds works or index funds and all these other great products are out there that can make you a lot of money over time. But the point is that you got to start putting your money somewhere to see it start growing and building that confidence. And then working with those professionals out there, they'll help you put a plan together so that you can become financially independent. So if you need help, I would highly recommend to go to letsmakeaplan.org. They're a nonprofit organization that is guaranteed interested in helping you get ahead and will put you with somebody who will develop a plan that'll make sure that you get on the right path to financial freedom. Thanks everybody for watching today. In Life, Mind, and Money, we focus on life. The reality is that if you want to live the life that you want and be financially independent, you've got to start taking action. And investing has to be part of that. So go find yourself a coach and learn and start taking action by putting money into products that will help you, your money become a bigger nest egg and really grow for your own future. If you haven't already done so, please hit that like button. It will help the show a ton. Also, leave your comments below, as we always want to hear from you. And then lastly, if you haven't done so, please hit the subscribe button, as we can really honestly use your support. Thanks again for everybody, and we'll catch you next time.